yours for many years it. With a lot of excitement and honor, I am the chairperson of Women in Engineering Affinity Group of IEEE SBGCI, present to you, the Women in Engineering Affinity Group. I extend my heartfelt gratitude and appreciation to our honorable guests for accepting the invitation and being here with us today. Our IEEE student branch has been active for about 7 months now. From day one, we have been planning to start a Women in Engineering Affinity Group at our student branch, but we had to cross many hurdles to reach that goal. We filed the petition to form the Affinity Group on May 25th, 2020 and got approval on the 29th of May 2020. The criteria needed to be fulfilled before filing the petition caused us to wait for a while. I could assure each and every one of you that it was surely worth the wait. We could not have achieved this without the constant motivation and guidance by our branch counselor, Binoj Kumar sir, our principal, Satish sir, and our staff advisor, Preetha ma'am. They have wholeheartedly addressed our issues and provided us with variable instructions. As the chairperson of Women in Engineering Affinity Group, I promise that we would work as a team for the benefit of women in engineering. Once again, I thank all of you for taking your time to attend this online inauguration in such a short notice. I hope to see the support of everyone present here in our future endeavors as well. Without further ado, let's move on to the inaugural sermon.
Once again, greetings to all the dignitaries, guests, and my dear friends. Let us begin our inaugural ceremony with the welcome address of Professor Preetha Philip, the Staff Advisor, Women in Engineering Affinity Group of IEEE Student Branch DC Vicky. Her tremendous guidance and support were the pillars of our Women in Engineering Affinity Group formation. Welcome, ma'am.
A very good morning to all. IEEE Women in Engineering is one of the largest international professional organizations dedicated to promoting women engineers to follow their academic interests to their dream career in engineering. This is a platform for budding women engineers to make lifelong friendships, acquire influential mentors, and make a difference for the benefit of humanity. Today, the Women in Engineering chapter of IEEE Student Branch, Government Engineering College, IDIKI, is happy to be a part of this initiative. Moving on to my assigned duty, I take this opportunity to welcome our beloved principal, Dr. Satish Kumar, to preside this inaugural ceremony. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
It's our privilege to have Mrs. Sharda Jayakrishnan, IEEE Chairperson Kerala Section, as the chief guest for the day. She has played a very strong role in the leadership fraternity of IEEE Kerala Section. She has also won the Art and Outstanding Women in Engineering Volunteer Award, recognizing her magnanimous contribution to the wide community. I welcome you, ma'am, to this inaugural ceremony.
Thank you.
Next, I welcome our guest of honor, Mrs. Mini Olana. She is the YAG Chair of Kerala Section, a very active member of Women in Engineering Section, who has also won many outstanding volunteering awards in IEEE Kerala Section. Thank you, ma'am, for gracing this occasion with your presence.
Thank you.
I also take this opportunity to welcome our faculty members, Dr. Binoj Kumar sir, the branch counselor of IEEE DC IDIKI student branch, and Mrs. Lina Mary. Also, I welcome the student coordinator, Ms. Devika, who has joined. She is the vice coordinator of Kochi Hub. My dear student members of this forum, it is your hard work that has made this Y chapter of GEC IDIKI a reality. I sincerely congratulate and welcome you all to this inaugural ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I welcome our honorable principal, Dr. C. Satish Kumar, sir, whose support and enthusiasm always inspire us to achieve the inevitable things. Welcome, sir.
Good morning. Respected Chief Guest, Mrs. Sharada Jayakrishnan, IEEE Chairperson, Kerala Section. Our guest of honor, Mrs. Mini Ulana, Kerala Section WAG Chair. Our student, Ms. Safa Abdul, WAE Chairperson, IEEE Student Branch of GEC IDIKI. Dr. Binoj Kumar, Branch Counselor. Dr. Lina Mary, who is at Chongyang, who will join shortly. Mrs. Devi Gayas, WAE Kochi Hub Coordinator. Akash, Chairman, IEEE Student Branch of GECI, and my dear students. It's a very glad occasion for all of us, where the Women in Engineering Affinity Group of GECI Idukki being inaugurated. First of all, I sincerely thank and express my gratitude to Ms. Safa Abdul and the other student members, along with the faculty coordinators. They were very active in forming the student branch also around 8 months back. And we all know that how a society treats in women is one of the strongest indicators of the success and health of that society. And of course, education is one of the most important means of empowering. But despite notable efforts by countries with providing basic education, there are approximately 78 crores illiterate adults in the world, of whom 2/3 are women. Around 13 crores children are not enrolled in primary school, of whom 70% are girls. And taking our case, we all boast of 100% literacy. Our literacy is close to 100%, 96% around literacy. But still, the literacy rate of women is in our state also around 4% less than that of men. So it is very heartening that the world's largest technical professional organization is taking special initiative in promoting women engineers and scientists and inspiring girls around the world. I hope you are aware about a scheme by Kerala State Council for Science and Technology, Back to Lab for women. It is observed that many talented women had to give up their career because of the motherhood and family responsibilities. So KCST has launched a scheme, Back to Lab, where women get research and postdoctoral fellowship for a re-entry into their career. For a period of 3 years, it is given. As far as our campus is concerned, we have around more than 50% of the student girls. And it is the second event of our college organized by a girl student during this COVID period. Hope all of you are participating. Many of you might have even participated in the online arts festival organized by our own arts club secretary, Hima. Around 300 students, I suppose, have participated in that event. I don't extend much. I congratulate Ms. Safa, the WHA chairperson, Professor Pita, Dr. Binoj, and the branch counselor, and all the student members for taking this grand initiative. I wish you all success for this program and hope more such activities will be organized by Women in Engineering Affinity Group of GECI Idukki, assuring all cooperation. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your supportive and remarkable words. It is my honor to welcome our chief guest, Engineer Sharada Jayakrishnan, to this auspicious event. She is the DGM of Terumo Penpur Private Limited and serves as the chairperson for IEEE Kerala section. Once again, welcome you, ma'am, and I request you to officially inaugurate the Women in Engineering Affinity Group of IEEE Student Branch GECI. Over to you, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you, Niranjana. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes,
yeah, ma'am. Okay. Thank you, Niranjana. Good morning, all.
Morning.
I can see many people. It's a Sunday morning. So glad to be here. So before I start, I think I must announce a great appreciation that has been received to Kerala section just today morning, incidentally, early morning today, that we have been adjudged as the 2020 best large section of the whole of IEEE. That's a big, big honor. We have close to 340 sections in Kerala, in the world, and Kerala section has been adjudged as the best section in this pool of sections. And the announcement came incidentally today morning from the President of IEEE, and I thank all the IEEE members who have assembled here, and I think it's a great day to be part of your inaugural event too. I could hear somebody clapping too, yes. Respected Principal, Noj, Preeta, Safa, I can see Mini over here, and all my friends, again, a good morning. I'm so happy to be part of this inaugural event, and V is always very close to my heart. I've been a very active member of AG in Kerala section all along. I've the opportunity to work closely with many of the members of the V Affinity group in Kerala section and in other sections all along. So when you look at, I know most of you would have already gone to the website of Women in Engineering to see what exactly it is. And I hear Safa also talking about how she had to have a big struggle to get through a affinity group for getting formed in your session, in your in SB. So I understand your SB has really revived. I'm so glad to know about it. Last year, you had actually worked as part of a joint SP initiative to get it revived. This is really, really good. You have to be proud that you are part of 100 student branches in Kerala currently, who is part of the IEEE Kerala section. Okay, and if I'm not wrong, you're going to be the 69th VAG to be part of a student branch. Meenie can correct me in her address if I'm wrong, but I think 69 is the count as of now. So why do we need a VAG first of all? At times I do think that do we really have to look at this kind of gender question at all in a state like Kerala? In a state like Kerala, where if you look at the number of students in a college, I know your principal, Dr. Vinoj and Preeta, all of you will support me when I say that almost 50% of the students in any engineering college in this state is girls. So why do we need such professional bodies to support girl engineers or budding engineers that are coming up? I think Principal in his address did mention a bit about it, mentioning about how we have seen that girls in the early, in your studies, and then as you move to the early career, you are really showing your worth and merit. But as we move up, as we try to move up our career ladder, or be it in any of the areas, generally there is a trend to set aside what we need and then go due to many cultural and personal restraints. I don't say that is not correct. There is always a balance that needs to be kept. We have all had our own challenges, but you should always think about what is it that with your capacity, giving to give back to the society as well. So that's where professional bodies like IEEE really come in. With the motto of advancing technology for humanity as such, we play a big role, IEEE as such is a big community of volunteers. It's not a structured, corporate body. It's a big pool of volunteers. So each and every volunteer has a responsibility to provide your skills, your merits to the community at large, along with evolving oneself. There was a question in an earlier session with our V-Chair, the current V-Chair, where a question had come up as to how do you see volunteering as such when you grow along with your career. So I like the way she answered it, which very much resonated with me too many a times. A volunteering activity, especially when it's in a professional body, aligns very well with what you are passionate about. You are passionate about science, and that's why we have all taken science streams, you have come to engineering colleges, you are passionate about science. So IEEE resonates that very well. Other than that, you have challenges in your corporate world or in your career, in your homes. Now a volunteering body actually supports you, or it manages you to bring out your innate capabilities in areas when you may not be able to show that fully in other other realms of your life. So it's very, very important that you manage not only your career and your personal life, but move along and have a volunteering capability. I generally say it needn't be always IEEE. It can be any forum which you can really relate. But if you join a voluntary body, you have to feel the responsibility that you're part of any community which is trying to provide your skills to the world at large. So all in all, this is the best community that I have seen, which can relate to your scientific passion, people who need to move ahead in your areas of interest. You take any of the cutting edge technologies in the world, IEEE is there. You have, you know, a wide opportunity of getting to meet people, to interact more so now with all these platforms. You don't have to go anywhere. You can you virtually meet any of the global representatives. Not only that, you can actually move along in other areas of interest. If you're interested in, maybe you're interested in having your skills honed in public speaking or in presentation skills, any area you take, you have opportunity in IEEE. So why women in engineering? Especially because we need still a support mechanism for many of our girls to bring out their internal passions, to show to the world that you are capable of doing a big deal. And so I'm really, really proud to know, to be part of this community. I have really gained myself. I'm sure many of the successful volunteers who are part of this community will have the same thing to relate. Now, there are two things which I thought I should also mention here. The bottom line is the way how you're molded to be an engineer, okay? Unless you have got your basics right from your teachers, from your peers, from the curriculum, if you don't have the basics, there is no point in having only the volunteering only the volunteering part. So you need to get your basics right, understand how to apply technology, that's what you're learning, understand it passionately, and then volunteer. You are going to enjoy your life all along. So with that, I think those were the few things I thought I will mention. Moreover, IEEE Kerala section is also very much known, other than for its technical skills and the way conferences are held or the events are held. We are also having the pioneers in humanitarian technology activities. I don't know how many of my friends know that the first idea of having a humanitarian activity or a group was coined in Kerala section under one of our past chairs, and it was here that the thought of forming site communities originally came up. So we have always pioneered in those areas, and under the current condition of the COVID, we are again working on an initiative called the Breath of Hope, which is largely run by volunteers from our section, along with doctors, engineers from other arenas. There are lawyers who are also part of the team. This team is actually working towards providing solutions, you know, concepts relating to respirators, COVID containers. There are also other robotic systems that are being brought up. So I really urge each of you volunteers, including there are many students who are part of it, you can all contribute to these kind of initiatives when you are part of IEEE and IEEE B. So Safa or Niranjana, can you bring up your inaugural sheet so that I can formally declare that the VAG is inaugurated? So Safa incidentally had asked me to present it. I didn't want to risk having a technical error, so I thought it would be good for the... Yeah, so I'm really glad and honored to mention that the V Affinity Group of IEEE, Joint Engineering College, Kentucky, is being officially inaugurated. So all the very best. I would like to see many events that are coming up from both the college and also the V group. I'm sure Mini will guide you through the different initiatives that she is going for the year ahead. So let's all join together to support the community and be good, very good, passionate engineers. All the very best. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your inspiring words. We are grateful to you for sparing time with us from your busy schedule. It's my privilege to welcome Dr. Mini Mangalman to the event. She is the Systems Manager for Cochin University of Science and Technology, and she serves as the Chairperson for Women in Engineering Affinity Group, Kerala Section. I invite you, ma'am, to address the gathering.
Thank you. At the outset, let me congratulate GEC Idukki, WIAG, which has been just inaugurated, and we are very happy to have you also join our wagon. We have Sharda. We had one more AG inaugurated last 2 weeks back. So this is going to be the 70th AG, and one more is lined up. Whatever I wanted to tell you has already been conveyed to Sharda. But at the outset, let me congratulate the whole team here, including GEC, all the volunteers from GEC Idukki, because all of us are a part of the team, for getting the MGA Outstanding Award for Kerala, which is really a great news for us, you know, today morning when we heard about it. So congratulations, Sharda, as a leader, and all of us being a part of it. So, as already mentioned by Sharda, I don't have many things to convey to you. She has already mentioned what V stands for and how we are doing things. But of late, we have been doing a little bit of, though things were very vibrant and active for the past few years, a few things this year we have lined up because of the changes in the current situation due to the pandemic, no face-to-face events. So we are regularly meeting the chairs. I see Amira and Devika also a part of it, who are really leading the team. And I invite Safa also to be a part of it. And regarding GEC Idukki, 2 years back, we had a plan to conduct a Shastra Vismaya, which is a very one of the flagship event of which was coined by WIE, which is being held as a joint program by IEEE site, IEEE YP, IEEE Life Members Affinity Group of Kerala Section, going to the community, preferably in a tribal and backward area. And we had identified Idukki also as one of the places, though it didn't happen previously. I think still there is a scope with this new renovated SB. And I should congratulate you because you were also awarded last year for a joint event with RIT. I think RIT was mentoring and handheld. Anyway, congratulations to the principal and the advisor and also the SB counselor for bringing it back and the student community. And we do hope that there will be a lot of activities coming up from GECI, and we will have a face-to-face, we will have a virtual discussion on how to move about. And we are also planning for a VXCOM training, which happened some time back. I think there are more of such requests coming up. So we may be planning for such kind of activities again. And I'm sure that Safa and her team will be doing their best also, because in the short time they have come up with a beautiful event like this with a very short notice actually, but still they've done it in a very excellent way. So congratulations to GEC Idukki team for bringing up such an event, and we do have a lot of expectation in the coming year as in this 2020 as well as in coming years. So with that, let me just conclude and do we will meet again. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mimi ma'am, for your inspiring words. Now I would like to welcome Dr. Binoj Kumar, branch counselor of IEEE student branch GECI, who has been the backbone and mentor of our student branch felicitation address. Over to you, sir.
Good morning to all. Respected Principal Sadir sir, Sharida madam, IEEE Kerala session chair, Mini madam, vice chair, Professor Preeta Philip, Y coordinator, Y staff advisor, student coordinators Safa, Devika, Akarsh, Niranjana, and dear members of IEEE. Happy to see that the Women in Engineering Affinity Group of IEEE student branch of a GECDK is being inaugurated. And I congratulate all the coordinators and volunteers of Y and IEEE SB GECDK for their vibrant performance. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank our principal Sadir sir for extending all the help and support to originate the student branch of our college. And as you know that our SB was not working in an active manner in the previous years, Sadir sir has taken personal interest in this matter and invited students from and volunteers from RIT to overcome this situation. And at this point, I acknowledge the help and support received from RIT student branch for organizing some joint benches. Today, I remember the day when Niranjana, I think along with Ross, approached me and we talked about the activities of student branch of IEEE in our college. From that level, we have grown up to a new horizon by organizing many, many programs jointly and individually. Today, I can claim that IEEE SB of GECDK is one of the best performing SBs under IEEE Kerala session. And while coming back to this IEEE Kerala session, you know that we are passing through a difficult situation. People around the world are facing challenges, and our duty is to transform those challenges into opportunities. That is what exactly the IEEE Kerala session is doing through numerous webinars. You can see a lot of webinars are being conducted under the strong leadership of Sharida Madam. I personally congratulate Sharida Madam for this type of activities, and I request all the blessings from her to the activities of IEEE student branch GECDK. And if you mention about the Y Women in Engineering Affinity Group of IEEE, we know that in almost all the colleges, Y is organizing varieties of programs. And no doubt, Mini Madam is behind all those activities. And I request Mini Madam for full support to the Y activities of IEEE SBGCBK.
Definitely, all the support.
One name needs a special mention, that is Professor Preeta Philip. Okay. Thank you, madam. My name needs special mention. That is the Y staff advisor, Professor Preeta Philip. She wonderfully supervised all the activities. And other things are like the coordinators. So we, the teachers or faculties, are just supervising. The students, the volunteers are the real working component in that. So I can point out some of the names like Safa, the coordinator, then Akash is there, the SB chair, Niranjana is there, SB secretary, all many students are there. They are working behind the curtains for the excellent performance of our student branch. I congratulate all the volunteers of Y and IEEE student branch of GECDK for their hard work. And best wishes for Y, and thanks to all the coordinators. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your inspiring words. We are grateful to you for your time and support. Now I welcome Devika, Kochi Hub Women in Engineering Coordinator, for a few words. Devika?
Sorry, there was a delay. Good morning, all. So I was a big coordinator of Kochi Hub. I'm happy to say that GECDK is the 26th VAG in Kochi Hub. So congrats to Safa and the entire team. And at the time of and acted for
okay, I think Devika has some network problems. Thank you, Devika. She has always been a support for us for the entire process in filing the petition. Thank you, Devika, once again. Now, I welcome Akash B, our student branch chairperson, to give the vote of thanks. Over to you, Akash.
Thank you, Safa. Let me begin by introducing myself. I am Akash, chairperson of IEEE Student Branch, Government Engineering College, Idukki. It is with immense privilege that I take this opportunity to deliver the vote of thanks. First, I thank Srimati Sharada Jayakrishnan, the chairperson of IEEE Kerala section, for inaugurating the Women in Engineering Affinity Group of our student branch. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
I also thank Dr. Mini Ulanath, chairperson of the Women in Engineering Kerala section, for gracing us with her presence. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Next, I thank Dr. C. Satish Kumar, our principal, for joining us for this event and showering us with his kind words. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Now, for a small talk token of appreciation from our side, we have a poster. I also thank Dr. Binod Kumar AC, our branch counselor, who has been very supportive from the time the student branch was active. A huge thank to you, sir, for being a pillar of support for us.
Thank you.
Mrs. Preeta Philip, the staff advisor of the Women in Engineering AG of our student branch, has also been extremely supportive. Thank you, ma'am, for your help and your presence here today.
Thank you.
Furthermore, I thank Devika, coordinator of Women in Engineering Kochi Hub, for being here with us today.
Thank you so much.
Last but not the least, I thank all those who are here attending this event for your constant support. Thank you once again. Over to you, Sapa.
Thank you all for your time and patience. We are extremely privileged to have all of you with us today in this occasion. The Women in Engineering Affinity Group of IEEESB, Government Engineering College, Idukki, has been successfully inaugurated. Once again, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to our distinguished guests, principal, and all the students for making this inaugural ceremony a memorable one. Thank you all.
Thank you, and stay safe all. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Sharda Madam, Mini Madam.
Thank you. We'll keep
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Okay, bye.